Where Cameroon? No, this is somebody's child. Another poisoning wahala. Hello guys, it's your girl Onana, and this is Onana Nation. So if you're new on this channel, a very special welcome to you and to all our returning subscribers. I love you guys so much. I appreciate you all for all the love and support. My people, wahala no dey finish you now, from one story to another. If you go back on this channel, for the past year, we've been talking about people silencing each other in Cameroon every single day. Worst of all, bushfallers. When they go back to Cameroon, every day we're making these videos, people don't listen. And I don't blame them. For some reason, you keep thinking that your friends are different. You keep thinking that your friends love you. I mean, when you see people silencing each other, dropping poisons in their food and all that stuff, you're thinking that, no, my friends cannot do this to me. These are my day ones. We went to primary school together. We went to secondary school, university together. These are my friends. They cannot do this to me. People still keep hoping. They still keep trusting people. So from all indication, it is like the word trust. We all have to take it from out of our dictionaries, from the way the world is going. It looks like nobody should be trusting anybody again in this day and age. Love everybody. I appreciate your friends, but probably we all have to start eating with people with a long spoon, because that's how it's showing. So this is the case of a young man here, a Cameroonian youth. He lives in France. December don't reach now. Everybody wants to bam bam. You want to chill with the big boys. So he left France and came to Cameroon and to celebrate Christmas with the family, his mom and dad, his junior brother and other cousins in the family. So in the evening, just say come on fellow soir, he went out with his guys, like, let's hit the town. He invited some of his friends from school, some of his old friends now in the quartier, like, let's go chill, your boy is in town. Hey, I'm back home, man, let's go hang out, what's popping? Gathered all his friends, went to this snack bar, and that's where you saw him dancing. I love Lasso's combo, baby. This is my morning voice. If I don't know how to sing, don't blame me. Blame my morning voice. So they were chilling now. They were shaking and they were dancing, and there were some chicks around there. They're just having fun, you know, as boys do. Got out in the bar, and when this guy was drinking, one of his friends played a smart one on him, dropped something in his drink. You know how you gather your friend in, I have to speak this part in pidgin. You know how you gather your friend in on a she don't like drink, and then in that circle you're thinking everybody loves you because you have a pure heart, you're happy to see your guys, you're happy to reunite with them for old time's sake, reminiscing, talking about stories that you guys used to do in the quartier and start laughing. How you used to go climb mango trees and get mangoes, how you used to go climb guava trees, and this auntie will be chasing you in the quartier, and you know all those funny stories, how we grew up. You'll be saying such things with your boys and you'll be laughing and you'll be feeling at home because these are your guys, these are your day ones. Unfortunately, in that circle, as you're talking and laughing and wishing good for them, somebody else is looking at you in his heart. He's saying, look at you. So now you want one succeed. Now you want to go bush. Now you want to feed this. So I'm just imagining, like, what an evil person would think. You know how we watch Nigerian movies and you see Mama G planning evil towards somebody's child. And all your own bikini travel, all your own bikini succeed, I go show you tonight. So that's what an evil person will be thinking. So the evil friend was there thinking, now you want to succeed, you want to leave me for back here, we'll suffer all we. May you go London, may you go Paris every day, bring money, can kind of show we, make our small girlfriend and the look we say will never succeed, now you want to succeed, make our family, let talk, the point we question and say, look at you, isn't that your friend, isn't that your age mate, why can't you succeed like him? So you know how we should put it, you know, the ever jealousy, then they compare. Now because of you, mama me, they love me every day, so I never succeed for life. Now because of you, my family, they call me, so I be failure, you go see. So as a friend was planning all this evil in their hearts, I mean, that's what an evil person would think. I would like to think so. So the friend now took an evil substance from the bag and dropped it in this guy's beer when the guy was drinking and he was not paying attention. Poor guy, so they say, they no say they with your brother, no, just see they all, no some they all, avec les frères. Fini drink mimbo or come on go house where papa God, all my don't disperse now, even in the end everybody has gone back to their various homes. He has gone back to his family home with his parents and his junior brother, only for grandfather to go climb for bed. My tummy, mon ventre, they say now wait till they happen. Grandfather woke up, the cough, they're like, what's going on? And all of a sudden as he opened his mouth and was coughing, silo sanki so and I saw blood, they come out, people that they holler, say grandfather wait till they happen for you. Grandfather, wait till they happen. Grandfather, you look up. She said, I don't know me. All I know is I was hanging out with my guys. I went out with my friends last night. I saw the cough. I saw this thing, they come out. People that they holler. I say, wait till they say. And so, these are the things we see in movies. How can this be happening? How is this possible? So grandfather, they cry, my belo, they only cough, this thing, they only come out. And so in mommy, the small brother, they everybody is shouting. So they carry grandfather and rushed him to the hospital. And they got to the hospital, the doctors did their best. And they were trying to see what's going on, trying to figure out, they're trying to see like what's going on. I mean, with the space of how many minutes, as doctor, the situation understand which kind of poison they give, how if you flush him out of his system, how if you help for safety grandfather. Doctors are still struggling, perambulating up and down the corridors of the hospital, trying to get some drips and injections and stuff together. And this is one thing in the West. Here, hospitals in Obodo-Ibo, in the abroad, we have emergency carts in every hospital. If not hard case, so you enter with heart failure, they get cupboard for seats where they open up. Everything for inside that cupboard is being determined and kept to prepare you to like save somebody from a heart failure. If you come for them with your kidney disease, emergency, where you can't die, so they get emergency kidney cart. They just open the kidney cart. Everything they need to save your life is there. But in Cameroon, when you run into the hospital for poison emergency, they get to go open some old medical cabinet for hospital. They find drip for this side, go find injection for that side. So this video, you know my videos, I always try to put something educative in there. If there's any Cameroonian nurses and doctors listening to me, make your crash carts, make your emergency carts in your hospital. Poisoning cases are becoming more rampant in Cameroon. Get a crash cart for poisoning cases. There should be drips in there, injections, and everything you need to flush out toxins from people's body, prepared and ready. So while the doctors and the nurses were still running helter skelter, trying to find out this one, gather this one, all those drugs and medications, and bring them all together at once, it was a little late, and grandfather just passed him like that. Or somebody's child, they played a fast one on him. Someone in his close circle, someone he called brother, someone he called mon frère that you're trusting with all your heart and soul. And this is the case that we are tired of talking about. Like, all my videos on this channel for the past, like, the whole of 2021, it was all people silencing each other. They don't silence some bushfire for Yaoundé. They don't silence some bushfire for Dualao. They don't silence some bushfire for Limbe. Like, my whole videos of last year was silencing. You guys remember the case of Karen Knowles, the beautiful young lady who opened her salon there in Yaoundé, and one of her friends played a fast one on her. How does it always happen? Always in a restaurant. They went out to celebrate her success, how she had opened her little salon there at BMRC, and she was doing well. So her friends had played the fast one on her, and they put her in a taxi. They not even go leave it for her, also put her in a taxi, gave driver 10,000, said driver carry you go. And Karen, the driver was like, "Chime don't see me put deposit on turn me a la maison. See me, I no get me change. Je n'ai pas la différence." Driver the tendency, I no get me change. Their friends, because they knew they had already played the fast one on Karen, they did not want the poison to start manifesting in their presence. And so the third taxi driver said, "No, follow the person a la maison. Take it, go house, go drop it for house. We don't care about the thing here, whether you get transfer or not, change or not. Just carry her and be going, because they know they don't already finish with tea. If she start manifesting in their presence, they are in danger, they are in trouble." So now, so they insisted driver carry me, they picking carry and they go. Halfway through the journey, driver they check through mirror, they see for back, picking they convulse, they cry, "Mon ventre, oh my tummy." And so carrying all this trouble for back day. Now driver finally park moto halfway for street, carry the picking wrong hospital. That's how that case happened. The other case was the other guy that came from France again. The other one was the other girl, that auntie that came from France. I mean, I have all these videos on my channel, you can go back and watch. The auntie that came back from France came and gathered all her friends that they went to secondary school, they went to lycée together. Auntie gathered them all, they go out or go spend on them. They were eating, they were drinking, they were living the good girl life and everything. Auntie spent her hard-earned money that she sweated to have in Obodo-Ibo, finish again for spend for them. In that evening, she gave all of them 5,000. She was not obliged to give anybody money. She took 5,000 and shared amongst all her friends. 5,000 for all them when they went at 8 or 9 with the commander evening. That's about 50 bucks. If 50,000 francs, if you compute it together, if you add it together, plus all the money she had been spending to buy them drinks and fish and chicken and everything, she must have spent about 200 bucks that evening. And that's okay. So after she finished spending the money on her friends, she left. The friend that she don't know, the guy that say, "Oh, you want come all Europe, can't give me 5,000 so for what I will be, for I will be 5,000 level people." So you can see the heart of man. People are evil. You mean well for them, you wish good for them, and they don't see the sweat you're going through. This girl has come from France. You don't know how she was sweating to make her money. You didn't even know the kind of job she was making. And then you're coming back to Africa, where you alone, you have a family, you have extended family, you have all kinds of aunties, nephews, cousins, nieces waiting for you to come give them money. So our auntie don't come back from bushes. So nobody sees your responsibility that you have to carry. Nobody sees the cross you have to bear. Imagine coming back from abroad. Everybody's expecting gift from you. Everybody's expecting money from you. Everybody expecting a lot of things from you. And then those are your family, at least you owe them that. What about friends that aren't even related to you? It was out of the kindness of this lady's heart, out of the largesse of her heart, that she thought of her friends, gave them gifts, took them out, still gave them money. If she don't look their money, me pray l'argent. Say money small, why they give them 5,000 for their for your eye now? You don't come out broke and give them 5,000, their level now 5,000. Now so they should don't plan the auntie, invite you for a second date. La première nuit la, we went out, you're the one who paid, you're not to sponsor. This tonight, we want to take you out, we too want to sponsor your auntie glad say, hey, people they for come out, their mentality don't change so. They want sponsor Bush for la, like, wow, I'm impressed. Now so you woke up there, mommy say, mama, oh, je suis avec mes amis oh, ce soir. Maman c'est ok oh. Faut être, you know, be careful. Faut être prudent. And so you come go meet up a friend them. They said they sponsor it tonight. They took her out that evening and they bought some drinks and stuff. And the money was still not enough. Now still until open posa move money add them again for the drink for cover shame. She helped the friends to pay for the bill for a night that they were supposed to be sponsoring her. If you be not say they pay for your own death na kwara they come so you know for even pay. So she sat there and was taking care of her friends. They paid. They put money on the table. It was not enough until completed the money. No say. All that time, so why do we eating and drinking? Some friend don't drop some fast wine inside a mimbo. How could she have known? Auntie don't finish chop now. Drink only if we come back for house. No fear, woke up for bed again. Her own case was even bad. Most of these cases that they even succeed carry them reach hospital before they even revive them. For some reason, auntie own case didn't even succeed for reach hospital. Auntie just the entire house on her floor, the fourth floor, so he. So the whole 2021 we'll be talking about these cases. There's so many of those videos on my channel. Just scroll and go down on Onana Nation. You see so many of those videos you can watch. So if these things keep happening over and over again, is there something we're missing? What should we be doing that we are not doing? How should we be taking such news? Should we be more careful? Should we be more careful of the people we call friends? Or should we just decline every invitation? Like, I don't even know the solution finally. So is it that when our friends invite us to go out, we should just be saying no, I'm busy? Or what are we supposed to do? We love these people, we trust them, we call them our day ones, and we wish well for them. Unfortunately, some of them are planning evil for you. And these things are happening not only to Bushfellas, to everybody. So I happened to Karen Ollis, a little girl there in Cameroon who was struggling to make ends meet. So you can see, these things can happen to anybody at any time. There's no limitation. So that's the direction that the world is taking today. They say the heart of man is desperately wicked. Who can know it? It's left for us to take good care of ourselves and be careful. The people that we're calling are the ones, you never know their heart. You never know what is going through someone's heart. And we just pray for the grace of God. God should protect us, and we shall not die untimely death. We shall not die before our time. We shall not die, but we shall live to declare the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. You know, God has great plans for everybody. There's a reason why He made us to be born in a country as tough as Cameroon, and we survive. What? There's a reason why we went through all those primary schools that we're climbing hills and mountains to go to. There's a reason why we're struggling in secondary school, kneeling down, and all those punishments and everything we went through. It was for something. It should mean something. It should count for something. Nobody should silence our lives when our lives are just about to begin. I mean, we don't have nothing yet. We're still struggling. So nobody should have to silence our life when we have not even started doing anything yet, you know? So yeah, we just keep praying to God Almighty. And Father, take control. Only you can watch over us. Only you can protect us. You see, the watchman watcheth in vain. If you're watching over a city and you think it's by your own strength, you're watching in vain if the Lord is not involved in it. Anybody who builds a house, a tower, and you think you're building on your own strength, you're building in vain if the Lord is not involved. So we gotta learn to involve the Lord in our life. And what a better way? Look around you. Look at the death of fish, the death of so many young people, the way the people are perishing. It's just a call to action. You should sit down and introspect. Ask yourself, what am I doing with my life? Is this where I'm supposed to be? Why don't I sacrifice, or why don't I commit myself to Christ? Why don't I surrender everything to Jesus? I've tried it with my own strength. It did not work. I've done everything. It still did not work. Why can't I try Jesus? So in 2022, everybody, hashtag try Jesus. That's our hashtag for Onana Nation 2022, hashtag try Jesus. You've done it in your own strength. It did not go. Try Jesus. That's the message. I love you guys. Stay safe, everybody. Have a blessed morning, afternoon, or evening, wherever you find yourself in the world. Stay safe, everyone. Guard your life jealously. You only live once. When you lose it, it's gone. Guard your life with all your heart and soul. I'll see you guys next time. If it is your first time on this channel, please like, subscribe, and share. I'll be seeing you guys in my next video. And if you want our channel to grow, if you love us, share our videos. Every time you come across a video as someone who loves a channel, your first reaction, like the video, drop a comment, share the video. I mean, these things don't cost anything. It costs 000 francs just to be nice and just to wish well for our channel and want to see us grow. All right, though. See you guys next time. Goodbye.